And if you don't know where to start, it can be overwhelming, even paralyzing. So let's fix that. Welcome to Simply Cyber, a community of tens of thousands of aspiring and active cybersecurity professionals focused on networking, knowledge sharing, and professional development. I'm Dr. Gerald, Auger, Chief Content Creator at Simply Cyber, inviting you to get the answers to your cybersecurity problems with hundreds of cybersecurity videos answering your frequently asked questions, interviewing industry experts, and live streaming daily cyber threat briefings hosted by me. Now get the stories and insights you won't find anywhere else. Hit subscribe now and dig into all the fresh content on the channel and in the community. Nothing should stop you from launching and leveling up. All right. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Monday, April 1st, April Fool's Day, episode number 590 of Simply Cyber's Daily Cyber Threat Briefing. We got a great show for you today. I am your host, Dr. Gerald Auger, and over the next 45 minutes, me, you, Space Tacos, Divine Dream Divine, Terry Stokes, Sabazot, everybody all up in Discord, because we're flowing Discord onto the chat today just to have a little bit of fun and mix it up. Mods, I do not have mod chat, so I have no idea if things go off the rails. We got a great show for you. We're all going to be shredding the top cybersecurity news stories of the day, and I'll be giving my expert opinion and analysis on each of those stories, on what it means to you as a practitioner. So how can you use this information to drive cyber risk reduction for your business stakeholders? And stay tuned. If you're looking to break into the industry, you're absolutely going to get value from this stream, because you'll be asked in any single job interview, how do you stay current on the industry? This right here is an absolute banger of an answer. On top of that, I got mod chat on the phone here. On top of that, the networking is amazing. Normally, chat over here is, you know, the traditional YouTube streaming chat, but we're having a little bit of fun on April Fool's Day. So if you're a regular, you know what's up. And if you're a newcomer, you're probably like, what in God's name is this nuclear mess? But it's going to be all about good times. I don't research or search or read any of the stories in advance. In fact, today's stories, I didn't even see the headlines because I was talking to DJ B-Sec in the green room. But I've got 20 years of experience. I'm going to give you my raw opinion and thoughts and kind of give you something that is beneficial. If you're a regular here, hashtag Team SC in chat. There you go. There you go. T Swifty. I love it. Jesse Johnson. All right, guys. Before we get into it, I do want to say shout out. What's up, Marcus Kyler and the Yeet Crew? You can finally be realized, Marcus, for the full Yeet. All right. Oh, okay. So the GIF war is coming on. All right. So, guys, I will tell you that last year on April Fool's Day, we did do Discord chat, and I couldn't keep it together on stream. So we'll see how it goes today. I do want to say shout out and thanks to the stream sponsors before we get into it, starting with my good friend Eric Taylor and the crew at Barricade Cyber. Barricade Cyber is dedicated to, what is Barricade Cyber dedicated to? They're dedicated to helping businesses from cyber attacks and recover from the damage done. Cyber attacks can cause massive issues for businesses and send dedicated, hardworking business owners into turmoil. But Barricade Cyber Solutions, they know how to mitigate the damage done by cyber incidents. Believe that. Check them out at barricadecyber.com. Let them yeet the threat actors out your environment. Maybe Metal Gear Solid. Oh, wait, no, that's Snake. All right, we'll do that. Yeah, there you go. Let Barricade Cyber get them out. All right. Also want to say shout out and love to Antisyphon Training, but more about them at the mid-roll. Guys, every single episode of the Daily Cyber Threat Briefing is worth half a CPE, so be sure to say what's up in chat. I know it's going to be a little weird because it's a Discord chat today, but say what's up in chat. Grab a screenshot. If today is your first day, hashtag first timer in chat, and would love to know if it's your first time, because I would love to know what your experience is. Also, we've got the Simply Cyber Community Challenge. Jenny or BSEC or mods, could someone... let me know who has the baton in live stream chat, because I can't see mod chat. All right, guys, we got a great show for you. I'm super pumped. Get your coffee. Get ready. So good. Do me a favor. Sit back, relax, and stay tuned. We're going to let the cool... Where's my mouse? We're going to let the cool sounds of the hot news... wash over us all in an awesome wave. I hope everyone had a great Easter weekend. You know, certainly recharge the battery, spend some time with family. Hope everyone's well. We can talk more at Jawjacking, where we will just we'll just let the Discord chat flow. All right, guys, be good. Let's get busy and get to work.
From the CISO series, it's Cybersecurity Headlines.
These are the cybersecurity headlines for Monday, April 1st, 2024. I'm Sean Kelly. Data of 73 million AT&T customers leaked on the dark web. On Saturday, AT&T said that data of roughly 73 million current and former customers was exposed on the dark web, including social security numbers and other personal info. The data appears to be from 2019 or earlier. Interestingly, AT&T chose to disclose the news on Easter holiday weekend, though the data had surfaced on the dark web roughly 2 weeks ago. AT&T said a robust investigation is underway, but so far they have no evidence of unauthorized access to their systems.
Okay, yeah, robust attack. Robust research is underway, but so far nothing. Like, it doesn't matter. You could find out that it was breached. You could find out it was, you know, internal threat or insider threat, like whatever. The cat's out of the bag. So I'm not really, you know, digging on this. I am an AT&T user, so I can't wait to get my letter in the mail. Ooh, like, my privacy and security is important to you, AT&T. Here is your tire fire of 2 years of identity theft protection, which I will be spammed after that expires by that vendor asking me if I'd like to continue on with this great service. So, you know, I guess the TLDR here is there's two things for us as practitioners. This isn't very deep, okay? One, you know, if you were involved in this leak, it's the same data that's been out there. So same standard protocol, be mindful of social engineering attacks. You know, it is tax season. So that information that get breached could be used to fraudulently file taxes on your behalf. That happened to me last year, except the threat actors made a mistake. I owed taxes last year, so that didn't work out too well for them. The other thing that I would point out here is that, and you know, for better or worse, I will say they took a page out of sports, the sports industry. So AT&T discovered this breach 2 weeks ago, and they waited until Easter weekend to release this news, right? The idea is most people are busy. Most people are, you know, around. This is going to qualify as making people aware, and AT&T did the right thing. But really, the impact and reputational harm is minimized because no one's really paying attention. You see this in sports all the time, like all the time, where they'll be like, you know, like somebody gets released from a team, like, you know, like whatever, like the Celtics will release somebody the same weekend as like the World Series, or, you know what I mean? Like it's not the lead story in any news outlet. And this is kind of similar to that. So if you are going to publicly disclose a breach because you have to, or because you felt compelled to, or whatever, you can control the narrative of it. You can control the schedule of it. And that is something to give consideration to. It's a bit more nuanced, right? Most people just want to get it out there and get back to work, but it is more nuanced. So include that in your tabletop exercises, potentially, if that's what you want. I'm right there with you, Alana. I can't with the Discord.
Accidental Linux backdoor discovery likely prevented thousands of infections. On Friday, Red Hat issued an urgent security advisory that Linux users should immediately stop using Fedora 41 or Fedora Rawhide. Red Hat said these Linux distros contain a 10.0 CVSS severity backdoor vulnerability in XZUtils, the XZ format compression utility. The backdoor was slowly introduced through updates by the alias Xia Tan, which is likely not to be a real name and possibly a group of individuals or even a nation state. A developer named Andres Frond discovered the stealthy backdoor by accident after noticing some odd SSH performance issues and Valgrind crashes. Some are saying Frond's discovery could potentially prevent thousands of infections. CISA has advised XZUtils users to downgrade to an earlier, uncompromised version and hunt for any malicious activity.
All right. So this was interesting. I saw Tom Lawrence posted about this on Friday last week. I think that was the first I saw of it. So basically, here's the deal. This is very clever. If you're running Fedora, which is a Linux variant, if you're running it, I think it's a Debian distro, if I'm not mistaken. I can't see mod chat, so I don't know. But basically, it has a backdoor baked into it. That's it, right? So we've seen this multiple times with threat actors and enterprising criminals where they will update open source code and introduce malware, whether it's information stealer, whether it's backdoor. Now, sometimes they'll do like a fork of the repo, which means like a copy, and then start making edits there and then try to use some type of typo squatting to get people to be tricked into finding that. This is like the legit distro for Fedora. And at some point, I guess before 41, someone baked in this backdoor. So yes, if you're running Fedora in your environment, you need to, well, you don't need to, but it is strongly encouraged that you roll back to a previous version, which can be problematic, guys. Like rolling back to an earlier version is not it. Like you don't just like push a button and call it a day. You have to do some testing and all these other things. So roll back. And then nobody knows right now what this XZ backdoor was actually, you know, designed for, right? Or, I mean, it's called XZUtils, but no one knows what it, who was using it for the backdoor, right? Like, was it Chinese espionage? Was it the NSA? Was it just some criminal group? Who knows? But the point is, it's there, and it's clearly malicious in intent. So, sweet find. It does have a CVSS score of 10.0. You could see right here, 10.0. So, like, definitely. I'm sorry, really quickly. It looks like it's the XZUtils is the program that is compromised, not Fedora. I guess Fedora just ingests the XZUtils as part of its build process. So, a minor correction there. Yeah. All right. So, you know, XZUtils, that is not malicious by design. Right. If you've ever done, if you've ever worked in like Linux or Unix, there's different like archive and compression applications or binaries in order to make files smaller, so you can like basically bundle them up and then send them over to another machine or whatever like that. So that's what that is. All right, let's go.
DHS expected to stop buying access to your phone info. Since 2018, Department of Homeland Security agencies, including Immigration and Customs Enforcement, U.S. Customs and Border Protection, and the U.S. Secret Service, have been buying access to commercially available data revealing the location of devices many inside the United States. Commercially available phone data can be bought and searched without judicial oversight. The data has been used to crack down on border crossings, identify human trafficking, locate undocumented immigrants, and for criminal investigations. Sources are now saying that DHS is expected to discontinue purchasing device data in the face of pending recommendations from the DHS Inspector General that the agency enact stronger privacy controls and policies.
Yeah. So, I mean, this story came out, maybe end of last year, earlier last year. It wasn't just DHS, Department of Homeland Security. It was actually a couple, right? So the CIA is not under DHS. They're their own thing. And I'm pretty sure they were looped into this. Guys, when we talk about data brokers, right? I've already gone off on a tangent on data brokers multiple times. But listen, data brokers can get data, enrich data, sell data. It's a vast ecosystem. We saw we've seen like just tapping and, you know, just gross uses. Well, here's the deal. In the United States, again, this isn't really a cyber story as much as it is a data or privacy story, but whatever. In the United States, the like CIA, the FBI, Department of Homeland Security, they're not authorized to investigate whoever they want in the United States, right? Like, as a citizen, you do have some rights and some privacy. So when they want to tap your phone, right? Or see, like, they want to see, like, who I've been talking to, or like, where did I go this weekend? They can't just have this, like, authoritarianism, all, you know, complete freedom access to just get into my business, right? So they have to request it. They have to get a warrant. They, you know, all these things that are controls in place to protect citizens from overreach of government and law enforcement, right? Okay. Somebody, I got to say, hat tip, you know, to the person who thought of this. Someone's like, guys, we've got budget. The data brokers sell this stuff. I got a buddy over at Data Broker Inc. Like, let's go. You want to track Jerry? We don't need warrant. Your warrants are no good here. Just throw some cashish, right? Straight cash.
Straight cash, homie.
Just throw some cash at this guy and make it happen. Done. So, obviously, a watchdog, an independent verification, identified this problem and said, wait a minute, that sounds a little sketch. We should probably not do that. And then it made a big pop and everybody got pissy. So now, months later, DHS is expected to stop. So even with all the bad pub, they kept doing it, right? Because, you know, no one said they can't do it. And even this story just says expected, right? Like, expected. So we'll see how it goes.
Vulture banking malware poses as McAfee security app. Security researchers have found a new version of the Vulture banking Trojan for Android. The initial version was discovered in March of 2021 and was being distributed through dropper apps on Google Play. The new version of Vulture masquerades as a McAfee security app that threat actors are tricking victims into installing through smishing and vishing attacks. The new malware has improved remote control over infected devices with commands for scrolling, swipe gestures, clicks, volume control, and blocking apps from running. The malware also better evades detection by encrypting command and control communications. To minimize the risk of infection, users are urged to download apps only from reputable repositories and avoid clicking on URLs and messages.
Ooh, hold on. We got an infographic here. Hello. Look at your color scheme, huh? A little two-tone red on black action. I see you. Very nice. Very nice. Yeah, exactly. Senfulous with a downloading virus GIF. Okay, so guys, check it out. This is pretty good. Mature, I would say. Mature level piece of malware called Vulture. It's a banking malware. Hey, 2015's on the phone. They want their banking malware back. Guys, before, like, for those who haven't been around, before ransomware became, like, the jam, banking malware was, like was where it was at. Like, you couldn't walk into a party without bumping into some banking malware. You're like, oh, geez, banking malware is here. No kidding. So I find it a little bit of a harken back, if you will, a little holler back, girl. If you will, can I, hold on, I gotta, I like to play with the GIFs too, okay? A little holla back, girl. There we go. Hold on, come on. There we go. Little holla back for the banking Trojan. So here's the TLDR, y'all. This is basically a Android-targeted piece of malware, and this is a perfect story if you would like to educate your end users, okay? Perfect. Hey, you know, hey, if you or loved ones are running Android for your mobile phone, you may want, like listen up. This could affect you. Essentially, here's the attack. They'll send you a text message saying that there's been a fraudulent transaction on your bank account and to call a phone number. Right there, you should be like, this seems a little sus. But we all get phone calls from, we do get text messages from like 5-digit numbers now, like pretty frequently, right? Like, oh, hey, just text this number and we'll tell you when your restaurant table's ready. Or, hey, like you got a package from, like legitimately you have a package from Amazon and the driver can't find your house or something like that, right? So that, like, we as, you know, citizens of a modern world have begun to get conditioned to receiving these messages, and threat actors know it. So incoming text message says, listen, there's a fraudulent transaction. We need to get it cleared up. Call this number. This number is, you know, Navy Federal or USAA or whatever. When you call the number, call center person picks up, they're the scammer, they're the fraudster, and they say, hey, listen, there's been, it looks like, this is the best part too, because they're telling you what they're doing and they're actually doing it. They'll say, hey, listen, somebody's installed malware on your phone and caused it to do bad bank transactions. I'm going to send you a text message to download a security tool that's going to clean your phone. And in reality, your phone's not infected and they're sending you malware to infect your phone. So like literally the complete opposite of what they're saying. And then once you install the malware on your phone, you're completely owned. Like at that point, you're like literally authorizing malware to run on your phone and it's game over at that point. So definitely educate your end users that run Android to not, I guess like the linchpin of all this is that tell them like this text message is the initial hook, and then tell them they should never call the phone number that's in the text message. You've got to go out of band, right? You got to go out of band. If someone says, hey, this is your bank and there's an illegal or fraudulent transaction, cool. Thank you for letting me know. Go to the bank's website and pull up the phone number or look on the credit card on the back and call the 800 number, whatever it is. Do not do it from the same person telling you there's a problem is not the same person whose contact information you should take. Full stop. Thank you.
Now, a word from our sponsor, Vanta. Managing the requirements for modern security programs is increasingly challenging. Vanta's trust management platform helps you quickly assess risk, streamline security reviews, and automate compliance for SOC 2, ISO 27001, HIPAA, and more. Plus, you can save time by completing security questionnaires with Vanta AI. Join over 7,000 global companies that use Vanta to automate evidence collection, unify risk management, and secure customer trust. To learn more, go to vanta.com/CISO. That's VANTA.com/CISO.
All right. All right. No current baton holder. Thank you, Jenny. Perfect timing, Jenny. Thank you. Guys, Jenny Housley and the mod team, absolutely phenomenal. Love it, love it, love it. Thank you, Jenny. All right, hey, guys, check it out. I hope you're getting value from the stream. I hope you're, you know, enjoying it. Happy April Fool's Day. If you're getting value, hit the like button right now on YouTube simply because it helps other people find the show. I'm loving the Discord chat. We can only handle it once a year. But I want to say shout out and thanks to the stream sponsors, Barricade, Antisyphon. I bid farewell to Panoptcy. I am still great friends with Brandon Poole. He's just focusing his marketing efforts in a different direction right now. So definitely appreciate the long-term support from Panoptcy, but enough about that. So Antisyphon training, guys. If you don't know about Antisyphon training, they're disrupting the traditional cybersecurity training industry by providing high-quality, cutting-edge education to everyone, regardless of financial position. They offer the students the ability to learn skills, practice what is taught, and engage with the community in a fun and inclusive way. Go to antisyphontraining.com to learn more. Seriously, this is the one I want. They have so many different classes at antisyphontraining.com, so go check them out. Like, literally, if you go to training and then go to pay what you can training, they have tons of it, and it's just phenomenal. Also, fun fact, stay with me at Jawjacking, but tomorrow, John Strand is going to be a guest on ACI Learning's podcast, and I wanted to do a raid. So let's talk about the raid during Jawjacking, okay? All right. Every single day we do the Simply Cyber Community Challenge. We have no baton holder right now. We need a baton holder. I know a couple people had volunteered on Friday. I don't know how we missed, but we definitely need someone to pick up the baton. Who's it going to be? We need someone. Here's the deal. The Simply Cyber Community Challenge baton is ISAT in chat. One of the students from the school in Massachusetts that I was working with. Oh, there's John. Yes, John Strand. All right, so we need a baton holder. So basically, you can blow up your professional network on LinkedIn. Just go ahead and raise your hand if you would like to step into networking, and we'll explain to you what you need to do. Also, Wednesday, we've got the Low Country Charleston Simply Cyber Community in-person meetup. More about that at Jawjacking as well. All right, guys, every single day of the week has a special segment, and Mondays is Simply Cyber Community Member Feature. So our community has tons and tons of amazing people in it, and I just highlight one every single Monday. Many of you know the people that get highlighted. They show up regularly. It's awesome. I spent about 2 hours yesterday with this particular member. I'd like to introduce you all to Kathy Chambers. If you don't know Kathy Chambers, she's a phenomenal person. She works over at ACI Learning. I've been friends with Kathy for years. If you've been enjoying the Jawjacking, how the Jawjacking's now getting cut off and put onto Simply Cyber Cafe YouTube channel, Kathy and Kimberly McKnight are the ones responsible for that. So I'd love to say, one, welcome and say hello to Kathy. And two, thank you, Kathy and Kimberly, for what you do. All right. Let's enjoy the jams before we get back to it. All right. We got work to do. Such a great show. Such a good fun. All right. Let's get back to work, y'all.
Activision urges users to secure stolen accounts with 2FA. A Discord user discovered an info-stealer database that targeted users of a service called Phantom Overlay, which provides cheats for Call of Duty and Counter-Strike across numerous gaming platforms. According to the Phantom Overlay developer, the database contains credentials for several million gamers, making the info-stealer campaign the largest ever to target gamers. It remains unclear how the malware was distributed, but multiple users have reported their Ethereum BTC wallets being compromised. Activision Blizzard has advised its players who may have clicked on a suspicious link to change their password and enable two-factor authentication.
All right. I just saw someone picked up the baton. Is it Jack Glatzenberg? Jack Glansberg. Look forward to your... Simply Cyber Community Challenge post. Thanks, Jack. And if you have any questions on what that is and how to do it, Jack, just ask. We're here for you. All right, so check it out. This is classic OG infection chain. So here's the deal. If you're going to cheat at video games, you don't want people to know that you're cheating, right? What are you doing? One second. Hold on. I got my dogs in here today. Hold on. My puppies. All right, so here's the deal. If you're going to cheat, you don't want anyone to know. So if you're installing and downloading malware that you think is for cheating, the reality is you're going to kind of be discreet about it. You're not telling people. You're not like, oh, I installed this malware up in here, right? So, but by doing that, you've infected yourself. And the funny thing is the malware isn't, the malware is stealing people's crypto wallets.
I'm a crypto evangelist. I love it, love it, love it.
Right. So anyways, they say enable 2FA to secure your accounts. Activision is telling you this. Here's the thing. As far as I can tell, it's not your Activision account that's being stolen or robbed. It's your freaking digital crypto wallet. So, I mean, I love Activision saying, hey, get in front of this. But in reality... you should install 2FA. You should enable 2FA on all the things, right? Like all the things, especially your freaking accounts that touch money. I'm not a crypto bro, right? I'm not Bitcoin to the moon. I'm not a, Shiba Inu coin or whatever those things are. Whatever. I don't care. I'm not going to the moon on a crypto rocket. But what I will tell you is whether it's crypto or traditional fiat or whatever, put 2FA on it. It's 2024. We've already covered multiple stories of threat actors getting you to install malware. Threat Actor Academy, they teach you how to be a bad guy, and it's really effective. So it sucks. Also, I might point out that I would imagine that a lot of kids would be the ones installing this who have even way less of a discretion when it comes to knowing that they're installing malware, right? So it sucks. Of course, kids, here's the thing. If you have like a family computer, right, and your kid installs the malware thinking that they're going to cheat at Call of Duty and finally get that dub, and now you log in to do like pay the bills, pay your taxes, whatever, you're screwed, right? You feel me? So be mindful of that. Watch out. And yeah, let's keep going.
macOS users targeted with ads spreading stealer malware. Researchers from Jamf Threat Labs published a report on Friday revealing yet another ongoing InfoStealer campaign targeting macOS users through malicious ads and bogus websites. Jamf said it discovered a phony website claiming to offer a free group meeting scheduling software, but actually installs stealer malware capable of harvesting users' keychain data, stored credentials in web browsers, and information on crypto wallets. The malware also persuades victims into bypassing macOS's gatekeeper security feature. The researchers say the sites cannot be accessed directly, but only through a sponsored link, likely to evade detection.
All right, so some enterprising threat actor has decided we're going to target macOS. Guys, it's like a complete fallacy that Mac can't be hacked, right? Like that was like the longstanding thing. It wasn't that it could never be hacked. It was that it had such a small footprint that if you were going to spend any amount of time and energy making malware, you want to get your biggest return on investment, right? So you're not going to target something. You're not writing malware for like some fringe operating system that no one uses. It's a waste of time, right? Hey, Billy DP, Team SC. So basically, hackers are targeting these users. Let me see. I was getting the dogs back into the Buffer Overflow studio here. So just give me 1 second. Excuse me. It's an info stealer. Which, by the way, just like wholesale. If I recently saw the output of an info stealer malware, it's insane. It's not just cookies and tokens. I mean, it's like literally everything about that machine. So it's kind of crazy, which is actually hilarious because one of the things that you can do with the information from info stealers is see like the entire file structure, like the directory hierarchy. So if you have, and what domain it's part of. So like, let's say you have a domain, like, I don't know, simply like, not simply cyber, but like say your domain is like walmart.com or right. Or whatever, like Walmart's your active directory domain. When you go on the dark web and you look at compromised dumps, right? Oh, here's a dump of info stealer stuff. You can see machines that have been infected that are in that Active Directory domain. So you can actually find compromised assets in your own environment by virtue of how effective InfoStealer malware is. Hopefully that made sense to everybody. All right. So Jamf is really good as far as like, you know, obviously protecting Apple products. They're pretty much the go-to. All right. So here's the thing. You may want to educate your end users. Typically, executives love running around on MacBooks. I don't know if you guys have similar experience. In my experience, there's been a disproportionate amount of executives that will use Apple products. Even if you're a Windows shop, ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for Windows up in here. I fly first class to change the forecast, Jerry. Get out of here with that noise. I'm not using this Windows machine. I'm special. So the malware appears to be a harmless DMG file, which is basically just an install file for a Mac. And then it tricks people through a phishing image. So this is why we can't have nice things. Pretty much straight into the point, okay? As always, you should have endpoint detection response, EDR, or anti-malware solutions, even on your Mac.
Denotis Rat targets Linux systems in espionage campaign. Security researchers have discovered a Linux version of a backdoor known as Denotis Rat, attacking Red Hat and Ubuntu systems in China, Taiwan, Turkey, and Uzbekistan since late last year. Denotus Rad is designed to monitor, control, and exfiltrate data from compromised systems. Researchers previously saw Denotus Rad compromising Windows systems and campaigns targeting government entities. The stealthy Linux variant gives attackers full control over target systems, enabling data exfiltration and espionage.
All right, hold on one second. A lot of Linux attacks today. And it's like every flavor of Linux too, right? There was an Android malware, which is basically a flavor of Linux. There was the Xe utils on the Fedora builds. We just had this Mac OS. Like, I don't know. I know we're playing bingo on Friday, but like, you know, circle gets the square. I think we've hit every variant of Linux today. We got Red Hat and Ubuntu here. Okay, so Denotus Rad, also known as XDealer. I haven't heard of either of these. Let's see. Security company ESET is reporting on this. So here's a fun thing. ESET, if you guys don't know, ESET, they are pretty legit when it comes to security research. Like if ESET releases a report on something, excuse me. If ESET releases a report on something, you should pay attention to it. I'll drop a link to them. Oh, I'm not even following them on Twitter. I am now. Usually the way I consume ESET's research is like when it gets, you know, put in the news, I'm like, oh, I pay attention. I'm not like proactively going after that. Like for me, ESET, Ponemon Institute, Cisco Talos, Recorded Future, Verizon Data Breach Incident Report, which is an annual. Like these are outlets that I find incredibly reputable and totally worth going to look into. Dragos, Dragos, when they do publish, they don't publish security research often, but when they do, it's legit. So, all right, what were we saying here? I got kind of derailed because of ESET. All right, Trend Micro reported the Chinese APT group as Earth Crawhang. This sounds like a off-brand. This sounds like an off-brand Marvel villain, Earth Crawhang. All your base belong to us, Earth Crawhang. All right, or like this is like a villain in a like a Paramount Plus streaming or whatever Peacock network, like one of these like second tier streaming services. All right. Anyways, now I'm just crapping on these things. What's the actual details here? So when they in a research lab, this variant of Denotus Rad was launched, and it creates a hidden file in a directory where the binary resides. Okay, it sets persistence through systemd. Oh, this looks nice. Nice little graphic with some detail put in here. Very nice. I'm trying to see, you know, like what's so special about it. Okay. Monitor, control, and exfil data. Okay. So, I mean, it's just a classic info stealing backdoor to allow further access. That's it. It's like a post-exploitation framework. Victims have been discovered in China, Taiwan, Turkey, and Uzbekistan. So for our American counterparts, this is probably not really something that's going to show up. And I mean, it's worth noting, if you are a security researcher or you're interested in becoming a security researcher, you could technically find this malware online and download it. VX Underground or Malware Bazaar might have it. As always, do not download or play with, quote unquote, play with malware unless you know what you're doing. I'm serious. Plaxico Burris, you do not want to shoot yourself in the leg with malware. You do not want to infect yourself with malware because you were, you know, researching and dorking around. So just be careful with that. But my point is, you could technically pull it apart and look at it.
Ross Anderson, professor and famed author of Security Engineering, passes away. Ross Anderson, a professor at the University of Cambridge, who is widely recognized for his contributions to computing, passed away at his home late last week. Anderson, who also taught at Edinburgh University, was renowned for his research including machine learning, cryptographic protocols, hardware reverse engineering, and breaking ciphers. Anderson's achievements include being awarded the British Computer Society's Lovelace Medal in 2015 and publishing several editions of the Security Engineering textbook. Throughout his career, Anderson was an outspoken defender of individual privacy and security.
Yeah. So if you, I messaged this on LinkedIn, I think yesterday. If you don't know who Ross Anderson is or what his contributions were to computer science and cybersecurity, you really should take a minute. This guy, I knew this guy, very nice guy, incredibly smart and really thoughtful, deliberate in his thought process. I always say it tongue in cheek, but literally I have a video for this particular one. Check this out really quickly. Simply Cyber Ross Anderson. YouTube.com. Simply Cyber Ross Anderson. I did three videos with him. I did three videos with him back in the day. And it was awesome. I'm bringing it up right here. Why are we bad at stopping cybercrime? I asked Ross that question. And why is information security hard? And I think I asked him, is Facebook considered critical infrastructure? Okay. I'm just going to pull up one. Right. So this is early Jerry. This is young Jerry or whatever, but this is Ross right here. Okay. So if you want to get to know him, there's probably 45 minutes of video content of me interviewing him. It's kind of like Simply Cyber Live, except I was producing and doing the videos themselves. You can get to know Ross. He did so many different things. He's got a free textbook, Security Engineering. Some of you may actually have downloaded and read it. He made it available, certain chapters of it, right? There he is right there with his book. He made it available. He made all his PowerPoint slides and lectures available. Just so, so good. And then finally, this is probably my favorite thing. This is so nerdy, but this is my favorite thing. Ross Anderson, the economics of information security. Okay, this is a really niche thing, but I freaking love the intersection of money and cybersecurity and how it influences decision making at businesses. He wrote this paper with Tyler Moore way back. I think this is 2007 or something. It's early 2004 maybe. If you get a chance to read this paper, it's fascinating. It's fascinating because it really gets into the perverse incentive to get first to market, all these things we always say, and a lot of the things that I say on stream about you can implement a new feature, you can implement 2FA, new feature you can sell, 2FA just adds friction for your customer. Let's go with new feature. The perverse incentives of technical design, of market, it's just a fascinating paper, and I will make it available to all of you. Pour a little out for Ross Anderson. Loved him and his contributions. So thank you, Ross. Hopefully it wasn't, he passed as peacefully as that can happen, right? All right, we're 8:43. I don't know how, let's get the music going. I don't know how we crush through all the stories and everything today. I basically I can't see mod chat. I haven't been doing all that. And usually we go a full hour, but today is a fast one. If you were here just for the news, consider it an extra 15 minutes as a gift from me to you. We can do some jawjacking. Bonus jawjacking time. If you gotta go, go. But I'm Jerry from Simply Cyber. We're gonna hang out, ask me anything. I'll show my puppies if you want to see my dogs, my dags. and we'll have a Discord chat going on stream the whole time. Happy April Fool's Day. This has been April 1st, 2024, episode number 590 of Simply Cyber's Daily Cyber Threat Briefing. Thank you to all of you for being here, showing up every day. Just showing up is half the battle, right? Shout out to Kathy Chambers, our Simply Cyber Community Member of the Week. And thank you, Kathy, for all your contributions. We definitely appreciate it. I'm Jerry from Simply Cyber. Until next time, I'll see you at jawjacking. Hold on one second. Hey, what's up, everybody? Hope you're doing well. Allow me to just get this Discord chat brought up on screen. Screen cap. Here we go. Hopefully everyone's doing well. Got a lot to jawjack about. See if you guys got the newsletter this morning. All right, there we go. It's a little janky, but it'll work, right? What's up, everybody? I am your host, Jerry Guy, coming hot off the heels of episode 590 of the Simply Cyber Daily Cyber Threat Brief. If you're new here, basically, we kick it after the Daily Threat Brief. We just kick it for an hour and, basically jawjack, share news, share tips, tricks, whatever. So if you got a question, drop it in chat. Mods, I can't see mod chat without bringing it on stage, so that's problematic. Try to get this as centered as possible. All right. Oh, Kathy Chambers, yes. Our pleasure. Exactly. The pain is in here. Hey, everyone. Janky, Valentino, good to see you. Very well-balanced newsletter today. Thank you. Thank you, Ross. We got a lot going on. Like I said, if you don't know about the, hey, John Hoyt, guys, if you didn't know, we're still trying to figure out the best way to do it. But if you didn't know on Simply Cyber Discord server. Oh, perfect. Darius Cater. Thanks, Jenny. On the Discord server, there is this, locals meetup thing. It's getting a little hairy, but like this locals meetup, you could see like Marcus Kyler and the Detroit crew, Chi-Town, right? Maybe you're in Kansas City with Toasty Pops, whatever it is. But there is a low country one, which is Charleston, and there's an upstate one for South Carolina. South Carolina getting double love. But the South Carolina low country one is having an in-person meetup on Wednesday in West Ashley. So if you're around, you want to come hang out, drinking's optional. I will have a beer with me. Casually Joseph will be there. Eric Taylor may make a appearance. I don't know. Space Tacos, best community ever. Thank you, Space Tacos. So Jenny Housley hooking it up. Have you done any of the case scenarios? I have not heard of case scenarios. I actually want to Google this and see what that is. Case scenarios. Let's see. Immersive online OSINT training. Ooh. Okay, you have my attention. You have my attention. Let's go. All right. What is this? Report style. This looks like this is awesome. Lazaro Rivera with the super chat.
Did we just become best friends?
Yep.
This reminds me of like an escape room, except like digital. It's been a while since I've updated, but did my performance review Friday and was told I've done a great job catching up. Yes, Lazaro. Also, you have to try to get Pirate Software as a guest for the Thursday show. Pirate Software. All right, hold on. Let's queue it up. Pirate Software. Let's see. Game dev, Twitch YouTube partner. Okay. Anybody know pirate software? I do not know pirate software, but if the community wants pirate software, I will go get pirate software. Makes it okay. So these case scenarios, has anyone done case scenarios before? This actually looks like a lot of fun. Let's just take a quick look. OSINT training bundle, $90. Okay, so get some training. Sinister Obsession, a case original for $25. Can we do this as like a group? Yeah, this looks fun. Darius Cater, I had not heard about this. I like, this looks cool. This looks really cool. I'm going to leave this up and dig into this a little bit afterwards. And it, of course, if you've done it in the, if you've done it yourself, please share in chat. It's kind of hard. I'm like managing multiple chat windows right now. Howard says pirate software is cool. Yosef. Nursing to cyber. Gerald, do you have any videos? What certifications did I start to get in cybersecurity? Yosef, I have, thank you, Jenny. So Yosef, really quickly, Security Plus, it should be kind of the first cert that you get. I will tell you, Yosef, certifications are okay. There's not a lot that are gonna make or break you as a candidate. Practical experience is more important. Yosef, I think I told you this the other day on Thursday, but I'll remind you in case you didn't, or if you had, then this is still true. Go to www.simplycyber.io/pivot right here. This is it. I literally made this resource, this cheat sheet, for people to do what you're trying to do, Yosef, and it explains everything, like all these resources, different certs, all those things. Also, if you go to simplycyber.io/book, lowercase book, I wrote this. This is a free download. It's like a, I don't know, 15-page book. And it's got 10 steps in order, Yosef, that you should do in order to break into the industry. I can't guarantee you a job in the industry, but I can tell you the optimal path. So go for it. All right. What's up? Pivot. I love the Discord jiffies. Can we please see your puppy dogs? Yeah, hold on one second. They're kind of like chilling out right now, so I don't want to pick them up, but that's them right now in real time. That is Ripley and that is Gibbs right there. And if Mrs. Auger is watching, she's probably like, ooh, the puppies. Lazaro Rivera with another super chat. Thanks, Lazaro.
Just become best friends.
Yep. He used to hack power plants for the US Gov before becoming a Twitch streamer and has three black badges. Holy Jesus. Okay. Dude, there's certain things in our industry that are like flexes. Black badge from DEF CON is a flex. Oh boy. You can't buy those. Damn. I love the doggies too. Yeah, we're a big dog family. That's so awesome. Thanks for the recommendation. We'll get him in the pipeline. I think later this week, Thursday, Jason Haddix is my guest on Simply Cyber Live. I'm like 99% sure. And Jason's amazing. And we're going to go through all the different stuff that Jason did. If you've ever even sniffed bug bounty, you know who Jason Haddix is. 01 Justice One says, how do we subscribe to the newsletter? Go to Kimberly Can Fix This. Well, thank you, Kimberly. the mod team, you guys are so good. Like, I read a question, it's already answered. Yeah, so go. The newsletter is something that I forget to tell people about, because I don't really try to pump, you know, all these things. But basically, if you go to simplycyber.io/newsletter, this is what it looks like. And this, you get it every Monday. It's been running for probably 2 years now, year and a half, 2 years. Every Monday at real value. It's awesome. I actually had someone reach out to me recently asking about sponsoring the newsletter, but I can't even keep up with my email. I think I lost track of that one. So let's see. Off to work, Angular. We'll see ya, Angular. Did we have any new people in chat? Was there any first timers? Was today your first time, anyone? Dr. Cyber's got breaking news. What's the breaking news? Got to hear it. Excellent. There you go. Just abusing Jiffies. I will tell you, not seeing mod chat really is a bummer. Like, I miss the mod team. So, come on, guys. What can I, is there anything I can do? Does anyone have any questions? Just schedule of events, just so everybody knows, if you're still here, you're a regular Simply Cyber community member. Wesley Widner, first timer, welcome to the party, pal, Wesley.
Welcome to the party, pal.
Yes, actually, yes, we can absolutely use the welcome to the party, pal, GIF. Love it. Welcome to the party, pal. Awesome. Marlar with a first time. Good to see you. Good to see you back in the fold, Valentino. So, this Friday, we've got a very busy day with Simply Cyber. So on Friday, it's bingo during the daily cyber threat briefing. From 12 to 1 p.m., I'm doing my quarterly State of Simply Cyber meeting. If you don't know what that is, ever since I went full-time with Simply Cyber, I see the community as my boss, right? Like, my mission is to serve you. And because of that, I feel it's appropriate that every quarter I hold a meeting where I tell you, basically I'll bring up what I told you I was going to do last quarter, and I'll hold myself accountable on completing or failing to meet those goals. And then I'll tell you what the goals are for the next quarter. So, you know, basically April to June. And then it's open forum, like feedback. Like a great example, I put it out to the community the other day, which course would you like me to develop next? Like, I was going to do the enterprise risk assessment one. And then I realized that might not be what the community wants. So, like, stuff like that. So if you're a regular part of the community, come on out. Hold on. Is that a first timer? Piano Pete says first time live. I know it's hard to get here live, Piano Pete. We're going to call that a first timer. Welcome.
Welcome to the party, pal.
Welcome to the party, pal. Yeah, I know, Becky Gaylord. I know. It's just so much going on. I wish I had better systems. I will say shout out to Kimberly McKnight. Kimberly can fix it. She's been helping me stay a little bit more organized. But... so, you know, we got Jason on Thursday. ACI Learning is sponsoring Worldwide Wednesday on Wednesday. So it's just a lot going on. The end of the month, I'm going to Vegas to film the TV show. So I'll be getting up at 5 a.m. I mean, well, not even 5 a.m. I'll be getting up at 4:30 a.m. The last week of April. To do the show from 5 to 6 a.m. So you'll get to watch the sunrise with me from the mobile studio. Hey, SubArt. Thanks for watching the streams on the regular. Good evening, Triple D. Thank you, SubArt. I will keep up the good work. I'll try my best. Not sure what my favorite brew is. I do try to find local craft if I'm traveling. Have a good day. If you got to leave, be well. Yeah, I know the Las Vegas Simply Cyber local crew are good people. CJ, Christina Paulika, sometimes Christina Paulika. Not sometimes she's good people. She's always good people. Sometimes she's in Vegas. Sometimes she is not. Yeah, Jesse Johnson. You know, that's the thing, guys. I can't be a poser. I cannot be a poser and be like, oh, it's too early when I'm on the West Coast. No, you guys get up for it. Why wouldn't I? I'm a member of the community. Valentino says, any news on our own brand of Simply Cyber Cybeer? Simply Cyber Charleston Chew. I remember you did some great labels on Midjourney. That's true. There is no update on that. That is, like, I thank you for reminding me, Valentino. No, the next kind of fun thing that you would be seeing is Black Hills Information Security and Simply Cyber are collaborating on a shirt, which will probably be available in the next month or two. Details to follow on that. That's just going to be a big drop on everybody's head. Like one day I'll go live and I'll be wearing it. Also, the mod team will have them. So look for that. Yosef says, can someone send me a link to my email if I put in Discord beginning 15-page book? Yosef, simplycyber.io/book. Simplycyber.io/book. What's the name of the game you play on Tuesday? I don't know what game I play on Tuesday. What game do I play on Tuesday? I don't know. Oh my God, I will tell you. I am like hardcore into Magic the Gathering Arena now. Ooh. I think today is like 90 days for me now. I can't get enough information in networking context. Plus, this is hands down the coolest cyber community ever. Joel Harrison for the win. Yeah. Any random governance tips for a noob? To security management, the goal is to get stuff done with a small team and lots of relationships with other departments and teams. Yeah, so cyber satyrs, any random tips, governance tips? You know what I would suggest? What I would suggest, cyber satyr, is set up meetings. Like, here's the deal. Set up, it's all about relationships, right? So set up meetings, like basically with the different stakeholders. So like, let's say, like legal, right? Maybe you just meet with general counsel and you tell them a little bit about what you're doing. And basically, in all the meetings I'm about to tell you about, make yourself available to them. Don't go to the meeting and be like, hey, listen, if a third party questionnaire comes through, I'm going to send it to you for legal review. Like, don't be that guy. Say, hey, listen, general counsel, I know that when there's a breach, we have to make a disclosure. I know when cyber insurance policies come through, there's legalese. What can I do as a cybersecurity professional to help you do your job more effectively, right? And then like go to, like every team has like a team meeting, whether it's weekly or biweekly. So think of like the engineering team, think of the HR team. Just ask whoever's in charge of those departments, be like, hey, can I come to your weekly meeting just once? Can I come to your weekly meeting and just for the, like, let me just be there for the first 5 minutes. I just want to introduce myself to the team. I want to answer any questions people might have. Just let you know who I am and what we're doing. So basically do that, cyber satyr, because you're essentially going to be developing relationships. And then when someone like Carl, oh my God, Carl. When Carl clicks on something and makes a mistake, calling you won't seem so bad because they already have a relationship with you, right? If they never had met you, they don't want to call and tell someone they don't know that they screwed up. No one wants to admit their mistakes, right? But if it's like, if you've broken down the barriers and made it fine, that's, you know, that's where it's at, right? And then furthermore, like when you find something on the wire that's a problem, you can call them and be like, hey, Carl, it's Jerry from InfoSec. Like, I just saw something weird. Like, you, it's all about that relationship, okay? Cyber Satyr. Oh, yeah. Dude, I went to watch Aqua Teen Hunger Force this weekend. And unfortunately, Fortunately, unfortunately, I got caught up watching college basketball. So, what's the best way to answer what are your strengths and weaknesses on a job application? I mean, personally, I mean, that's really an individual thing, but I mean, your strength, I mean, I would say the strength should be something that completely aligns with whatever the job is, right? So like, don't say that like, you know, if you're applying for a GRC analyst job, a strength wouldn't be that like you make great meat marinades, right? Right. So whatever the job is, make sure the strength aligns to delivering on that job. And then as far as weakness goes, I mean, you can do the layup, which is basically like, oh, I'm overcommitted. Like, oh, I care too much, or I, you know, like whatever, like these kind of like cheesy answers where you basically it's like really a strength hidden as a weakness. Or you could be honest. You could say, hey, listen, like cloud security, configuring Azure infrastructure isn't really a strength of mine, but you know, I'm taking this training, and I'm hoping to get better at it, right? So you could openly point out something. So I guess in conclusion, the strength should be something that aligns with the job, and the weakness should be something that's almost not a problem for that business, okay? Xena, got some Xena in here. I do make great marinades, Xena says. Holy crap, can I just tell you guys, I had a terrace major steak on Saturday night, which is like the butcher's cut. Like you can't even get it in grocery stores. Holy Jesus. It was very, very good. Very good. I did sign up, put my email, never got the book for free. Is there a link to download it? Thrifty all day. Did you check your spam filters and stuff? It definitely fires. There's no question that it fires. Meaning the email sequence. So, Careless Soul says, new here. This seems like an awesome community. Seems like an awesome community. Believe me, Careless Soul, you will confirm that this is an awesome community. I wanted to know if help desk is required as an entry-level job to get into security. Help desk is not required to get into InfoSec. Help desk is a great onboarding path to get into InfoSec, though. I'll say that, right? Especially if you don't have a good if you don't have a good background in IT. Yeah, so that, okay, so if you don't have a background in IT, help desk is a great way because you basically see all the problems, you hear end users talking, you can pivot nicely into GRC or SOC if you do help desk. And if you do help desk and there is an information security office at that business, you can move laterally from help desk into InfoSec if you do the networking right, right? So Thrifty All Day, you sent the screenshot here. I can see it right here. This is the confirmation page that you did in fact get it. You will receive an email to the email address that you put in, you know, within a few minutes of seeing this thing. So make sure you put in your email address correctly. And Thrifty All Day, did you just sign up a minute ago? I mean, I can go into the back end system and confirm that it's there. Oh yeah. If you've never had Terrace Major, it's got a street name. Like it's drugs. It's got a street name. I think it's called, what's it called? It's technically a sirloin, but it's like, there's not a lot of fat on it. Oh my God, it's so good. Cyber Warrior. Leatherneck Cyber Warrior. I see you. Ooh-rah. Self-proclaimed dry rub creator for smoked meats. Love it, love it, love it. Group hug. Yes. Why HR do not like overqualified professionals? Yeah, I mean, Gil, I don't know. Maybe, The only thing I can wrap my head around with HR and overqualification is that they are concerned that if they put you in the position, you're going to leave because they're not paying you for like the level of experience you have. So I don't know. All right, let's see. I'm still looking. Paul Rudd. Wagyu doing? Guys, I got to tell you, I freaking love having Discord on stream. It's so fun. HR people are special. That's right. Yep. Great Easter. I can't wait for Tidbits Tuesday. I don't want to spoil it, but I'll just tell you, I messaged my good friends, Matt and Brent. I don't know if they're in chat right now, but Matt and Brent. And I said, I got a group chat with these two guys. And I said, hey, I need a show. Any recommendations? And they recommended something. I was like, I don't know, guys. And I turned it on. And I went to bed at 1 a.m. last night because I binged watched this show. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. So good. So good. Hey, Jazzy Jazz. So anyways, I'll tell you what's up. We do have a pretty strong Marine Corps faction within the Simply Cyber community. Eric Taylor, notably. All right. It was called So Jazzy Jazz. Yeah, I used to play haiku on stream on Mondays at 4 p.m. Eastern time, but I stopped doing that back in, I think, January is the last time I streamed haiku. Space Tacos, whatever happened to Simply Cyber Coffee Adventure? That's a great question. Josh Mason's dad and I, his coffee was great. I liked it. We needed to just set up a meeting to figure out logistics. Because, like, basically, he's one person. So can he support a business of roasting coffee? That was the real question. Space Taco. So we do have a coffee. It's just nothing ever happened with it. And Josh has been super busy too. So that's what's happened. Oh, I remember. I knew that there was another thing for April Fool's Day. Gary Sturgiotis wanted me to drink Crank, which is maybe last year, right? For those who don't know, last year, there was a company that wanted to like collab with me and have a Simply Cyber coffee. Cause I drink one of these every day. So I said, send me three different beans. And if I want to switch my bean, then we can sell it. Like, I'm not going to say like, oh, this cup of coffee is XYZ coffee bean. In reality, it's like Starbucks French roast. I'm not going to lie to people. So I drank the three coffees. I end up not liking any of them. And we didn't, that was the end of it. But the very first coffee was called Crank. And that particular episode, if you were there, you know it. I was like out of my mind, like literally over-caffeinated out of my mind. I was a mess. And Gary Sergiatis wanted me to get on the Crank again. Yes, exactly. Mod chat knows what's up. So funny. You guys are the best. You guys are so funny. So, oh, Luke Canfield, you tried it too? Luke Canfield, you tried the Crank? Oh my gosh, it was something. Exactly, Neo. It was like going full Super Saiyan. Oh my God, you know, Bob's Burgers, I feel like Bob's Burgers is a completely underrated show. That show is amazing. The characters in Bob's Burgers are awesome. Gene's my favorite, in case anyone's wondering. Cyber Hamburglar with a 12-month sub. Thank you. Thank you, Hamburglar. Appreciate that, Taylor. And yeah, the Crank Coffee was something else. It was it was something else. Just a reminder, if you are studying for Security Plus, it's on your roadmap. I know some people, maybe Yosef, maybe Kathy, maybe others, every single Thursday, Jesse Johnson over at Slay Security Plus is doing an interactive live stream helping people learn to pass the Security Plus exam. So definitely giddy up on that. Oh my God. I will tell you, I'm a very inclusive person, right? But I will tell you, with coffee, I'm kind of snobby, right? Like Folgers instant coffee. What? No. Jesse Johnson. Yeah. Bob's Burgers. I just feel like it never reached me. I mean, I know it's on mainstream TV. It's just, I just feel like people don't know enough. People don't know about it. Laura Flores. When was that exactly? I do remember Jerry saying he was over caffeinated at one time. Yeah. I don't know what episode it was, but it was something else. Hold on. Something came through here. I have a question. Thrifty all day. No experience. How can I get experience? If I don't get a job, after reading your book, you will show what first job to apply to. All right. So what the hell? So Thrifty all day. The book is a macro level plan, right? The book is like the bigger picture on how to execute to get in. The cheat sheet, Thrifty all day, that's where you're going to get experience. Okay. So, simply. Do we have here Thrifty all day? Hold on. I got to get Thrifty all day in here. All right. That will give you more, lower tier, lower level explanation on how to get in Thrifty. Okay. I have caffeine intolerance. Can only drink decaf. Oh, Logan. Oh.
Catch me outside. How about that?
Oh my God. I would lose it. I don't know what I would do. I mean, coffee is like important to me. Oh. Cheap coffee is his own APT. Leatherneck, that's awesome. I haven't had Black Rifle coffee. I know Black Rifle coffee is like very popular. What is cybersecurity? The pain asks. Is that like Microsoft Word? Where am I? This isn't Google. Okay. When you're overqualified, I try to answer a question like, why do you want to work here? With, I'm looking to join a company where I can grow within the org to stay within a single ecosystem. Seems like I'll be able to do that here. Good answer, Rex. I like that. I just looked up strong coffees on the interwebs and it seems there's a brand called Devil Mountain Black Label. 1500 milligrams of caffeine. Holy Jesus. Does that come with like a warning label? Like you know how like when you go skydiving, you have to sign like a waiver? Like that coffee comes with a waiver? Yep. Carrie hasn't had caffeine in almost 3 years. Yeah, let me do this one, you know. Cyber Logan, I thought it would suck at first, but I didn't really notice a dip in energy. Still drink my decaf every morning. Yeah, you know what's interesting? Like, as far as like age goes, it seems like the youngs, like Monster Energy drinks. Like, I see my students all the time with like these tall boys of, you know, energy drinks. So I don't know when that took off, but that's a thing. Haircut Fish is in the house. Welcome to the party, pal. What are we doing on time? It's 9:18. We're great. What do you do? What you do, Jerry? I don't know. Marcus Kyler's off caffeine. Really? All right. Oh my God. I remember, do you remember Jolt? Jolt soda? I don't know if you guys remember Jolt, but like when I was a kid, like you couldn't even get Jolt. You couldn't even get Jolt soda. and if you could find it, you'd like hoard it as a kid, and then you'd just be like, ah, like just you drink it as fast as you could. It was like basically like drugs for children. Want an AeroPress, but have an espresso machine, pour over. See, here's the thing. For me, like, yes, I have a pour over kit, but I don't have time for that. Like, I have to have an entire French press every morning because I can't, to me, I know it sounds ridiculous, but like spending 15 minutes making one cup of coffee, I just don't have time for that. So, all right. I'm not off caffeine, very addicted, had to cut back. Yeah. So what's up, guys? I mean, like, this is just like a regular Simply Cyber community love fest, like hanging out. I mean, I'm happy to answer any cybersecurity questions, but I'm also really enjoying just kicking it with y'all. Is that a YouTube channel, Slay channel? Yeah, it is. So here, check it out really quickly. This is not a, actually, you know what? I'm going to add this to my, thing. So I think it was Thrifty All Day. This is it right here. Slay Security Plus. Jesse. Hey, can we look at this right here? It's in my favorites. Yes. Right there. There we go. I love it. It's in my favorites. This right here. Look at this. This is Jesse Johnson bringing the hype. Cold brew's the way to go. Oh, yeah. I will tell you, I appreciate Starbucks and its consistency. Like, I really appreciate Starbucks and its consistency. Like, when I travel, I like to go to Starbucks. Actually, when I travel, I make my own French press. I have a whole travel kit. I will tell you, when I went to Phoenix the other day, I just brought, you know, the Starbucks Vias? Those work for me. Yeah, the GIF of Jesse is awesome. There's this one too, Kev Tech. Some, like, not everybody in the community has GIFs, but we got a couple. We got Josh Mason, Kev Tech, Jesse. There's some good ones in here. There's one of me, but I'm not going to post it. All right, let's go. Any place I can get free cybersecurity policy documents? Yeah, I think SANS actually has some. Let me see really quickly. I'm pretty sure SANS has policy templates. Yeah. So here, I'll drop this link in chat. Who asked the question? Gina Ghani, there you go. There's the SANS ones. I think CIS has some too. Oh, you can just download them like that. Yeah. So definitely get up on that SANS one. Looks like I've never heard of CSIRT, but they, again, like this link, I can't vet or confirm or not, but this is another one. Good place to get started. Also, you can ask ChatGPT to whip you up a policy. I got a video for that. We got 6 minutes, six more minutes. Yeah, there's that one for sure. What did you put in the chat for me? The chat is going too fast. Just scroll back up, Thrift Daddy, or Thrifty All Day. Just, you can scroll up in chat. And I tagged you on it. Let's go. All right. Thrifty All Day. Yeah, right here, Thrifty. Slay Security Plus. Look for the Dancing Jesse. Here, let me do this. I guess I didn't tag you. Let's see. Oh my God. I'm looking to get into OSINT. Oh, okay. I'm looking to get an OSINT. The only cert I found is very pricey. So, hey, okay. So for OSINT, I would not get certified in OSINT. There's no reason to do that. What I will tell you is that I'll tell you two things. One, again, these case scenario things, I've never heard of this before, but this looks fun. If I was going to learn OSINT, okay, two things I would do. One, TCM Academy actually has, oh my God. TCM Academy actually has an OSINT course that's pretty good. Where is it? Keith's got so many freaking courses now. This one right here. This is a good course. I've taken this course. I liked this course quite a bit. Another thing if I was going to get into OSINT, right? This guy right here, Michal Khan. This guy is an absolute must follow. I love this guy. Michal Khan, here. Follow this guy for OSINT as well. Yep, Trace Labs is another good one. Although, yeah, Trace Labs is good. Trace Labs, I got a video for that. Here's Trace Labs. I'll drop a link in chat for this as well. Trace Labs does these awesome events. Michal Khan, actually, Wild West Hack and Fest training. So if you're going to Deadwood this October, I'm pretty sure Michal Khan is doing a training. He did it last year. And where is it? Here it is, right here. Next Level OSINT. Dude, I'm telling you, this is awesome. Like, here's the thing. I try to travel as little as possible because I work my tail off and I love my family. And I really don't want to be away from my family if I don't have to. Taking this training would just be really, really fun and awesome, but it wouldn't help me professionally. So I can't justify spending an extra 2 days away from my family. But if I could, this training I would absolutely do. This training, I hope this becomes available for asynchronous consumption. Michal Khan is awesome. I love myself some Michal Khan. Also, if you want, just for fun, like I said, I got a video for that. Simply Cyber, Trace Labs, VM. I got a video right here on how to roll your own. Yeah, roll your own Trace Labs VM right here. So basically how to build your own, you know, custom operating system, like not like the operating system's there, but the tool set that comes on it. This is a great video. I'll drop a link here. I also want to point out that Trace Labs has like rebuilt their VM. So it's better now than it was before. Take care, Jenny. Guys, hey, mods, I know the mods right now are in mod chat chatting with each other. I'm having FOMO of not being in mod chat right now, which is hilarious. Can you show Michelle's book? Yeah, hold on one sec. All right, so Michal Khan also wrote this book right here, The Phantom CISO, and it's awesome. It basically explains how you can like build yourself up and how you can basically assert yourself as an information security leader at a business. It's very well done. He's got it priced super affordable. I think it's like $15 or something on Amazon. He priced it to cover production and shipping, not for profit. Michal Khan, just a really heady guy. Love him. We should have Michal. Has Michal Has Michelle been a guest on Simply Cyber Live? I feel like he should be. Yeah, of course he was. That's when we talked about the book. Right here. Yeah, if you want more Michelle Kahn, if you want more Michelle Kahn, here is a link to that. All right. All right. Happy April Fool's Day, everybody. I hope you've all enjoyed the Discord chat. You know, it's been silly. It's been fun. Once a year, we do it. Lord Processor, do you have a discount for your course? I'm trying to buy the course and join the Simply Cyber community, but I'm not a financial where I need to be able to buy it at the price it is now. Well, you can be a member of the Simply Cyber community for $0. Like, just showing up is how it works. And Lord Processor, just keep an eye out. Whenever there is sales, I make it abundantly clear to everybody. Maybe we'll run a maybe we'll run a tax day special, like, you know, April 15th, right? 4/15 tax day. Maybe we'll run 15% off or something. I don't know. Let me think about it while I'm not streaming. All right. Oh, cool. Yeah, Dark Knight 1989. Echoing that Michelle Kahn is dope. Can you have Michelle and the Differ Queen on the same live stream? Space Tacos. When you say Differ Queen, are you talking about Differ Diva, Elon Wright, or Differ Queen, Jessica Hyde? Now, no one calls Jessica Hyde the Differ Queen, but as far as I'm concerned, she's royalty in the Differ space. She's so good. Simply Cyber, coming from New England area originally. Whoops. Cyber Logan says, coming from New England area originally, would you recommend relocating to the Carolinas? Yeah, I did. I love it. Yeah, I left Massachusetts in 2009. Never going back. I mean, I'll visit, but like, I don't want snow and cold. Guys, when you're inside for 3 months because it's like freezing out and you know, just kind of like dark all the time, no thank you. Zmif says, isn't there a payment plan? Yeah, yes, there is. If you want to buy the course in installments, you can do that as well. All right, let's keep going. Happy early birthday, Jesse Johnson. Let's go. Jessica Hyde and Michelle Kahn on the same live stream. I don't typically have more than one guest, but we could do it. We could break the internet. I really want to get the studio, like the live in-studio thing set up. I'd like to get OBS set up. DJ B-Sex always making the OBS look so slick. Brent B is moving to South Carolina in May. Welcome to the party, pal.
Welcome to the party, pal.
Yeah. Well, Brent B, South Carolina is not cheap. What's your course based on that you're selling, Gerald? Good for people with no experience. Yep. Well, so Thrifty All Day. Here, let me show you what we got. Thrifty All Day. I have two courses. Hey, Jax. Good to see you. I have two courses. One is Cybersecurity 101, and this is a full semester-long course that is like, this is a college course. And basically, this is for somebody who has zero background in IT or information security. And this will give you an inch deep, a mile wide of curriculum. Now, this Cybersecurity 101 is really just to educate you. Like, you will not get a job because of this course. You know, like, just being real. But this will give you the knowledge foundation you need to be able to get the knowledge you need for a job, if that makes sense, right? This is it's called Cyber 101 because it's literally a foundational anchoring course for everyone. And it, you know, like I said, it should take 3 months to complete this course. Then Thrifty All Day, I have the GRC Analyst Masterclass, which this is the what I'm known for, I would argue. This class right here, this class is all about GRC Analyst, which is a specific role in information security. And this one, I cannot promise you a job. There's no way you can ever make that promise or guarantee. But I will tell you, there are people who have gotten a job because of this course. Space Tacos in chat is one example. Again, I'm sure Space Tacos had other things going for and just crushing it, but that these are the two courses I currently offer. Also, I'm curious what the is that it for the music? Hold on. Let me do this. All right, here we go. Promise me a job. Yeah, right. So I asked everybody, or I asked the community for a to vote on the what class y'all want next. Entry-level vulnerability analyst is what people are voted. Almost 50% of the community, 600 votes, almost 50%. All right, there we go. Looks like Vulnerability Management Analyst Masterclass could be the next course, just so you guys know. The people have spoken. All right. Oh my God. Yeah, billionaires are screwing up. Billionaires are screwing it up. Taxes. Yeah, taxes are rough. What are some well-known web scanners? Jazzy Jazz asks. You'll have to be more specific when you say web scanner. Burp Suite is a great, tool for like web application security probing. Shodan is a great web scanner. It scans the internet and pulls information. Securi is a good one. Piano Pete says, which of any of the Wild West Hack and Fest trainings would you recommend? Well, let's take a look, Piano Pete. Let's take a look. All right, here we go. Again, you should choose a training that works with your profession, right? Or where you want to go. hold on, gather around the campfire. Let me bring this over here. So this one, advanced endpoint investigations. This is if you're a differ person. Enterprise attack initial access. This would be if you're a red teamer. Breaching the cloud with Bull Bullock. This is if you're offensive security minded. Intro to pen testing with John Strand is excellent if you want to become a pen tester. This breaching the cloud with Bo Bullock is super smart. I love myself some Bo Bullock. Hacking AD fundamentals, that's a great entry level course with Dale. Wade Wells, wading through logs, CTI 101. Like, dude, here's the thing. You cannot go wrong with any of the training at Wild West Hack and Fest, okay? Whitney and Eric from Lima Charlie now, formerly of Recon InfoSec. Awesome people. Guys, I think the real problem is not being able to take more than one training. If I had to choose one training, I could go to one and could only go to one, I would likely do the OSINT one with Michelle Kahn, though. That would be my jam. All right. Space Thrifty All Day says, can you possibly have space tacos? Any of your members who got a job and no experience doing your program? I don't understand that question. I got my current job auditing with zero prior experience. There you go. Oh yeah, space tacos, of course. Of course. Hey, Piano Pete, love it, love it, love it. All right, guys, it's 9:40. I do love kicking it, but let me check my calendar. Let me check my calendar. Missing mod chat. I got to meet with, I don't got to meet. I have the distinguished pleasure of meeting with Kimberly right after this meeting. What the heck is this? Oh, I see. Let's give it a few more minutes, huh? What do you guys say? 5 more minutes? Yeah. Woo! All right. Ric Flair, woo. You only get it, we only get it once a year, so let's go. Shout out, first time catching you live, but been watching every day, studying for Sec Plus. Nice, Joe Foglia.
Welcome to the party, pal.
Welcome to the party, pal. Have a good one, Cyber Logan. And then can you do a live stream on anyone who got a job with no experience, possibly with your help? Well, I can tell you this, Thrifty All Day. Let's do this, Thrifty All Day. All right, here you go. Start here, Thrifty All Day. Here is a set of videos I did interviewing Simply Cyber community members who pivoted in to the industry, including a stay-at-home parent, a law enforcement officer, a paramedic, a religious leader, a pharmacist, a mechanic, marketing executive, heavy equipment operator, K-12 teacher, and an accountant. So here is multiple examples of what you're asking me for, Thrifty All Day. And I do like to deliver. I do like to serve, and I'm super pumped that I have a video for that. It's like one of my favorite things to say. I will tell you, Thrifty All Day, it's not easy, right? Like, you can't, like, it's very competitive at the entry level. So, like, you need to get a lot of experience. You got to do a lot of networking. You gotta grind, right? I mean, there is no easy button getting into cybersecurity. I will fully transparently lay that out up front. All right, just a reminder, everyone, that on Wednesday, April 3rd, there is a Simply Cyber community meetup in real life in Charleston, South Carolina. If you are interested or you're around in that space, the local community meetups, there's one for many, many different cities. The Charleston one, I am the ambassador for, and it will be at Frothy Beard. What questions do you have for Jerry? Drop them with a Q. Thank you, Kimberly. Live resume review sometime. Oh, I forgot to mention, on Friday this week, we're doing the Discord AMA, live AMA in Discord. Also, Kimberly Can Fix It suggested we do a backdoors and breaches with the community live in Discord. We definitely want to do that. Yeah. You can go on Discord. If you're in the Discord, you can go on Discord. You can see it here. And you can see, if you click on event in Discord, at the very top of the Discord, you'll see event. And then here is the series of events. You'll see April 5th at 1 p.m., May 3rd at 1 p.m., et cetera. These are when we're doing the AMAs. These also coincide with when we're going to be doing bingo. So don't sleep on that. All right. Later, bro cacker. All right. Kathy Chambers is out of here. Have a great day. All right, guys. I have thoroughly enjoyed the stream today. Happy April Fool's Day. I hope you enjoyed Discord chat. We're going to put it in the trunk, put it up in the attic. We'll bust it out next April Fool's 2025. All right. I'm Jerry from Simply Cyber. Genuinely appreciate it. Look forward to Jack Glatzenberg, Simply Cyber community post. Be good, everyone. And until next time, stay secure. Have a great day.
If you enjoyed that content, keep the cybersecurity train going by connecting with the other Simply Cyber community resources. We have the Discord server that's lively and always keeps the conversation going. You can connect with me directly on LinkedIn. And also every single weekday morning on the Simply Cyber channel, we're doing live daily cyber threat briefings, 8 a.m. Eastern time, as well as Thursday at 4:30 p.m. We're doing live stream interviews with industry experts, and we produce videos that we push out every Wednesday.